All right, in this video, you're going to see me learning how to do the car curry stuff, which is Fortnite building, basically. But you'll see. What I just picked up is healing water, and we're going to use that to heal our boo-boos that we got when we fell down the cliff. All right, and this is the car curry, which if you watch some of the gameplay trails, you'll see people conjuring things like these crates here. Which the car curry have uses in and out of battle. Which as you'll see here, I'll use these crates to climb up this cliff. But I'll do that a couple times as I get through this whole cave that I'm in right now. Here, we'll do this real quick. Karakuri are special devices used by hunters. They come in various shapes and sizes, and they help with locating and downing kimono. If you look on the bottom of the screen there, you'll see where there's a indicator for pressing LB. And that's what allows me to conjure the Karakuri, but I currently don't have the threads. So we'll have to use the hunter vision by holding. We'll have to go mine these two little locations right here. Oh, and if I paid attention, I would do it this way. All right, we gotta get up that cliff. We can only hold up about 12 of them at the moment. So we'll just conjure a couple, then we'll grab this guy. Same deal, we're gonna conjure some Karakuri. I'll go back and grab some thread. And here it's going to put me through the using crates to attack monsters with. So we'll get a little bit closer. Conjure a crate. And the higher the crate, the more damage you'll actually do. So if you stack a bunch of crates up, you'll do more damage. Right, hit that one for 74. And killed it outright. This lizard bloom will actually come in handy, so I believe that this will allow me to disassemble them. Cool. Didn't play around with that when I was actually on the PC version, so. And now we've hit a lovely loading screen. What it wants me to do, but I'm gonna look for things to pick up. Nice to stay topped up.
Yeah.
This is the Harugasami way. This is where things start to take off a bit, and you'll actually see me fight the Rage Tail here in just a second. But first, we're gonna build a camp. If I'm the perfect place for it, we'll put it right about here. Right. First off, you have to unblock the dragon pit. Should have paid attention. This is the dragon pit. And dragon pits basically give you fuel to craft the camping stuff. So right now, if you look on the side there, you'll see the dragon pit capacity. And when I go into the dragon category, you'll see here at the bottom. It takes 5 to make a camp, so we'll just put it right there. Now get me a fast travel point. We also need to build a campfire, which if you buy the digital deluxe version of this game, which I believe it's called the Karakuri Edition, you actually get another thing that you can spawn here as well, but I don't seem to have it on the Xbox version. And I know that lady is over there hurt, so I'm just gonna warm up real quick. Which we'll get into this a little later, but obviously you can play online and pick missions from your campfires. That's our friend Rage Tail. Yeah, I hear Rage Tail. I got you, friend. Now we have to hunt the kimono to protect the camp. It's best to look around and grab things as you walk. Because after you help the blacksmith out, she actually will start crafting things for you. So I know you need a bunch of ancient lumber to craft a bunch of stuff, so it's one good thing to be on the lookout when you start out in this game. Shouldn't have done that. You can request assistance as well. It works a lot like Neo, where people can join the Tori gates. But pay attention now. As you see here, it's telling me to conjure a crate. So we'll block it. Quick 3-stack. Come on, you. And he'll run into that, which will give us the perfect opportunity to do this. He's gonna slam. I broke it. And I don't know if you guys noticed, but you can also target certain body parts. Ah, man. I I don't know if you can cut body parts off like you can in Monster Hunter, but I'm certainly gonna try. Oh gosh, I didn't think I was gonna die at that time. I got a little scared. Down. Alright, he's running like a little punk ass, so we'll stick out here and heal real quick, grab some items like this food that you can eat. You can see, food has a wide variety of effects on you when you eat it. So we'll eat real quick. Let's see.
My friends are there with one. No. Petarazo.
And apparently somebody joined my game. So that's cool. Alright. I'm gonna pay attention now. Let's see here. There is another dragon pit, so we'll grab that.
This will help.
Excellent.
You guys notice that my katana is now in an unbound state, and it's working a little bit more like a whip, so I got a little bit more range on it. But if you notice that bottom left bar there, it's being drained slowly as I attack. Quick heal.
Too much for you, huh?
Indeed.
Cool. Apparently there's lost letters you can collect, guys.
Here I am.
Just found that out myself.
It's enraged.
Indeed.
It's enraged indeed. Get there and help my friend out. It's really important to pick up things like the small mist crystals and all that, because it lets you upgrade your dragon areas. Woo! that tree. God, I needed that lumber, so that worked out well. Yeah, that guy's got that giant wall that he's shooting from. I'm gonna spawn my stack of stuff. He's dead. Thanks, Megalady. That was pretty cool. Alright, one cool thing I want to show you guys is... You saw me pick up the lost letter. There's something else around here. I just have to remember where he's at. I think he's over here and to the left. Yeah, this little guy right here. There's a couple of them hidden around the world, and they are... Let's see, I want to call them Tsukumotos, but I think that's wrong. Tsukumo. They basically are like your little companions, like the Palicos and Palamutes from Monster Hunter. But you can upgrade them at campfires. It's pretty cool. But yeah, guys, that was the Rage Tail hunt when you first start. There's one thing that I missed that I wish I could have got. I wasn't expecting another hunter to show up for this one. So, one cool thing that he does is he spins around and conjures a corrupted tree, and it spawns around him and works a little bit like a brush stroke. It's really cool. I will try to get a another video of that one, but I appreciate you guys watching the video. If you have any questions about Wild Hearts or anything like that, feel free to let me know in the comments. Like, subscribe for more. Appreciate you guys watching. Take it easy, guys.